Welcome. Today we're going to talk about the multimeter, how to use multimeter in electronics in electrical issues. Multimeter used in measurement and testing, we can measure the AC voltage, ampere, ohms. We can make testing of continuity, which can be used to test different components like wire, fuse, diode, transistor, transformer, inductor, and the other components. You can measure frequency. You can measure gain of transistor. We have this hole here. This first is for plugging this, use it for this black terminals, which is common, or you can terminals as S terminal. Normally must be plugged here. Must be here. And this red, which is live one, must be plugged here in order to measure a lot of measurement like a voltage, resistor, capacitance, if your multimeter can measure capacitance or other measurements. But here is used if you need to measure ampere, which is larger amperes, let's say 5 amperes up to 10 amperes, and fused amperes can be measured here. But normally we are using this point and this. So we're going to start with the first measurement, which is, let's start with DC voltage. So in DC voltage, you can use here, you can use this point up to this point. It depends on the amount of voltage you're going to measure. Let's say you're going to measure this 9 voltage battery. So your pointer must select the points which is larger compared to the amount you're going to measure, but it must be near to the amount you want to measure. So it is 9 battery voltage, so you must select 20 voltage. But sometimes if you are going to measure the amount which, let's say, unknown amount of voltage, you can select anywhere and start to adjust in order to have good displayed digits, in order to have good digits in your display. Let me measure this voltage. This battery, it is positive, negative. So you must place positive here and negative here. It is 7.69. If you exchange terminal, it means it will give you negative sign. So you must place in order to get you, but the result will be the same even if you exchange the what? You exchange the terminal. So if you want to use this point here, which is milliampere, it means your multimeter will display over limits. That means that this rod is larger compared to resistor units. So I mean this the voltage measured is larger compared to the ability of multimeter. That is why it display or error, which is over limits. Or battery exceeds the limit or capacitor for measurement of multimeter. That is why you must use this 20 in order to be able to measure the voltage of this battery. If you use this larger, very large, it means that some decimal will be approximately will be reduced. 7.57. It means that some decimal place will be reduced, will be more approximation will be happen when you are going to use very larger units compared to measured one. So here, press here for the better result. Let it measure AC voltage home supply. This will be over limit because it's small to home supply, which is 220 up to 250. So you must use this point here. 235 AC voltage. 35 what? But here will be over limit. Here will be over limit. Over limit. Let me measure resistance here. So if you don't know the values of resistance you're going to measure, you can place anywhere. You can place anywhere and start adjusting in order to get good digits and the decimal place in your result. So it is 0.97, so K ohms, 0.97 K ohms, which is approximated to 1 K ohms. So it's better to be measured at this point. This is 9.7 K ohms. You can adjust 9.6 K ohms. So it is good to be measured at this point. Yeah. It is approximately 10 K ohms. If you want to use this, it will be over limit. The same to this one. Over limit. So you must adjust. You must adjust. Yeah. 32.7 K ohms. Okay. You can make continuity testing. Continuity testing here. Continuity testing is a test used to in the kind of testing used to check if current can flow from point A to point B. There is no faults or damage between at the middle between point A to point B. Here there's high isolation between like in body. But when you make contact of this point and this point, it means there's no any damage and the current can flow from this point to this point and passing around these wires up to this point here. So high isolation, low isolation. That means that if you make contact between this wire at this point A and this point B, the current can be flow. But here current can flow, but if the wire will display over limits, it means that no current will flow. It means no current will flow, but here current can flow. We can test this fuse. Fuse have a wire inside that connect this point to this point. That means that wire that connects this point to this point can make current flow. And the fuse is good. But also this one is good. But this one is bad. It means that the wire has been the wire is blonde or burn. It is bad. It is good. It's good. Also, you can use this to check the if inductor is bad or good. But inductors is just the wire that coiled around, let's say ferromagnetic materials or other kind of material. So it must have continuity. That is good one. This one is good also. You can check transformer also. That means that primary winding must be in continuity to each as wire all wires in primary winding. Wire between primary winding must be. Wire of primary winding must be in continuity each other, and wire of secondary winding must be in continuity in each other. This one must be in continuity with this one, but it must not be. Wire of primary and secondary must not be in continuity. As you see, no continuity between primary and secondary, but primary to primary must be in continuity. The same to this one. Continuity, no continuity. So this one is good. If there will be continuity between this side and this side, this will be bad. And if no continuity between this and this, it's bad also. Let's check diodes here. Diodes. Positive, negative, cathode, anode. So current flow in this direction. Current flow, but can't flow in this direction. Flow in this direction, not flow in this direction. Because that arrow to flow in one direction only. So in order to test it must have continuity in this direction, but must not be in continuity in this direction. So this one is diodes. That means that it is cathodes. This one is this here. This color is this line here. This color. That means that it is cathode, it is anode. So current will flow in this direction and it will not flow in this direction. The same to this one. Current will flow, but the current will not flow. Will flow. Can you check red diodes also? Anodes, cathodes. Anodes, you can check to know if this is anodes and this is cathode by checking the size of plate inside of this bulb, of this glass. Small plates inside of this it's showing is anode. That means it's anode. Small plate is anode, larger plate is cathode. So put cathode, anode is this side is the anode, this side is cathode. So connect will turn on and it must not turn on in this direction because current will not flow. Anodes, cathodes. Current can flow and will turn on. It is good also. Nothing will happen. It's good. This one is bad. This one is bad.